Here are four things that you might not know about the solid extrude command. We have a circle sketch here, and I want to extrude this up to this face of the cuboid. In the extrude command, with the extent type set as a default distance option, I can simply select this face, and the extrude automatically extends up to this face. It would be reasonable to assume that if we confirm the extrude command and change the size of the cuboid, the extrude will parametrically adjust itself. However, if I do that, you can see that the extrude does not change accordingly. So what is the problem here? Let's go back into the extrude. When the extent type is set to distance, and you select a face, what the program does is that it will simply measure the distance between the sketch plane and that face. Once that value is determined, it is set in stone. It does not behave in a parametric way. So if you need to extrude up to a face and keep it parametric, always make sure to set the extent type to two object before selecting that face. With that, when the cuboid changes, the extrude would change accordingly. I have a circle sketch here, and I want to make a cut that is an offset from the far side of the cylindrical face. If I begin the extrude command, set the extent type to two object, and select the cylindrical face, you will see an extend option popping up, which gives you a two body or true body option. While working with extrudes, this option will rarely come up, but it can be quite useful. In this case, the command recognizes that the extrude can be performed based on the near side of the cylinder or the far side of the cylinder. Since I want to perform the cut a distance away from the far side, I will choose a true body option. Let's set an offset distance, which would have to be negative in this case. We have a sketch here that straddles two separate bodies. If we use this sketch to perform a cut, under Objects to Cut, we have the option of selecting which body to cut. Let's remove one of the bodies from the cut. If we go on to pattern this cut, the pattern will continue to honor the condition set during the extrude command and limit the pattern to that body. This is the case even if you extend the pattern beyond the body that was selected for the cut. This can be very useful for creating patterns within a specific boundary. We are all familiar with using the trim tool to trim surface bodies. We have a series of surface bodies here. I want to trim them into an overall conical shape. The conventional way of doing this would be to extrude a conical surface and use this surface body as a trim tool. Instead of doing this, we can simply perform a solid extrude. and change the operation to intersect. So the next time that you need to perform cutting operations on surface bodies, it is useful to keep in mind that the solid extrude command can be used to interact with surface bodies.